Well, this is the line that we hope to see the Flying Scotsman approach soon. In other words, I can see Bruce over there. I'm not very well up in
yes, gentlemen,
yes, yeah. In well.
You get locked in.
Thank you. Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this afternoon's special walk. First time that we've attempted to have a walk and a train ride. That was the train ride. The hardest part is still to come. I'm Bruce Stait, and I'm your leader this afternoon. Two of the other Cotswold Wardens are with me, John Hunt and David Payne. We're all regular walkers, and we usually come out about twice a month leading walks in the Cotswolds. But we don't normally operate in this area. We usually get more towards job. This afternoon's walk is scheduled to be 4.5 miles. We've got a little bit of walking on the road to do, but not very much. But just when we are walking on the road, don't straggle about all over the place, otherwise I'll sort of lose a few of you to the oncoming traffic. And then we've got to walk across the fields, some of which lies right alongside the railway line, which we should see Flying Scotsman and the train perhaps once or twice while we're walking. We're going back through Hales Abbey, and I'll stop and talk to you about Hales Abbey when we get there. This of course is Wincombe Station, which in actual fact is about a mile outside the town of Wincombe, for those who don't know the area too well. Wincombe's an old Saxon town, the capital of Mercia, and a very interesting place to look round. One of the four abbeys in Gloucestershire is the one that used to be in Wincombe, the one we're going to look at in Hales, one in Cirencester and the other one in Gloucester. So we're well equipped for monastic houses. If everyone's ready, and I think we can make a start, I'll lead the way and these two gallant gentlemen will keep at the rear and answer any of your questions should you have any.
That's right. Yes.
Especially
when you've got a bit of
sun out.
Nice
mirror group newspaper.
BBC cameraman. Is it ITV News? Oh, yes.
No.
You see it on roads and things round here. It's all close.
Oh, yes.
So you've been over the river?
Yes.
Some kind, isn't it?
Yeah.
It looks just like a farm and two or three houses.
Yes, it is really.
It's probably the outskirts of Didbrook, isn't it?
Didbrook, you say?
Well, there's that Crook Cottage at Didbrook, isn't there?
We're going past it.
We are?
Oh, yes. Oh. Wouldn't miss that.
Oh, you must take a picture of that.
Wind.
Jerks
when you're walking along,
doesn't it? I try not to.
We'll get down by the abbey itself.
Oh, there's an abbey down here, is there?
Yeah, what's left of it. Behind these trees, Don, on the right. Mm.
Now, what did he say the name of this place was?
Hales Abbey. H-A-I-L-E-S.
And what year was it established? 12?
1200 and something.
12, that's right, yes.
Yes.
And what did he say, Henry VIII, when he came? That's what when he was became... that's when he kicked the Catholics out, didn't he?
That's right, yeah. Well, this is one of the great holy spots of the country.
It would have to be in that case, wouldn't it?
Century cottage. I was hoping that we were going to have someone in digging in the garden. I could ask some questions about the house, but oughtn't to be. But it's probably one of the best examples of Crook Cottage that there are in this area. And you can tell from it's Crook Cottage because the beams extend right to the ground. So I'm told. And of course they have to be original. 15th century.
Which wasn't working just for a minute.
On the other road, perhaps.
20 minutes, I think, before the fight.